This brother has a history of dealing with our people. And he's going to share some of his words of encouragement with you all. Glad to meet you, brother.
Good afternoon, good evening. Power to the people. Now y'all don't know nothing about no power, so don't laugh. You're not gonna take out no power, you're trying to get some. That's why you're sitting up in this room right now trying to support young people, right? Isn't that right? We do know why we're here, right? Why are we here? Why are we here? Why are we here? Let me explain something to you. I was invited here by the Power Coalition to talk to young people, to talk to our communities. I talk to communities all across the country. I talk to communities in Europe, in Africa, in Asia. And I talk to a lot of young people about mobilizing themselves to deal with their situation. You know, black people in America seem to think that the problem is violence in our community. The problem is not violence. You've been fooled. You've been tricked. You've been hoodwinked into believing that violence is the issue. That's not the issue. If you knew what the issue was, you would begin to organize yourselves to deal with it and not deal with the symptoms of the issue. Every living thing on this planet is violent. Even a bunny rabbit. Threaten a bunny rabbit's little babies and see how violent that bunny rabbit is. Violence is in your DNA. It makes you protect yourself and defend yourself when your life is threatened. If you did not have the capacity for violence, you would not be able to defend yourself. Did you know that? Does anybody understand that? If you don't believe me, you can go ask white folks in the biology department. Violence is innate in all living mammals. It's a means of protection. It's a means of hunting. Could you picture a non-violent lion? Have you ever seen a non-violent cheetah? Huh? Violence is innate in mammals. What we have to deal with is aggression. Aggression is the socialization of violence. White folks are aggressive. They're violent. If you want to stop violence in America, put a yellow ribbon around the Pentagon. It's the most violent institution on the planet. It's carrying out murders of people of color around the world in your name as we speak. Don't turn to the young brother in the street with his pants hanging down around his butt and a Glock in his waist and tell him that he's the problem. Our children belong to us. If you can't talk to your child, who will? If you can't organize our youth, who will? If you are misinformed about what you should do, how could you inform your children? Ignorance isn't bliss no more. What you don't know will get you killed today. What you don't know will get you killed. Well, having said all of that, I hope I can disavow you of the idea and the notion that you're in this room to stop violence. What you're in this room for is to organize our community to empower our children so they will not have to resort to violence in order to be heard, in order to be seen, in order to make a way for themselves. America was conceived on violence. Ask the Native Americans if you can find one. America was conceived and expanded on violence. Ask the Mexicans about Texas and California and how the crackers got it. They took it with guns. We didn't come over here on the Mayflower. We was taken away from Africa with guns. The thing that white folks feared the most when they established this society, a society based on white supremacy, that they feared the most, that defend himself and fight for his freedom. And in order to terrorize them, they had to convince you that violence was negative. While they were using violence every day to enforce their rule over you, you've been hoodwinked. Violence ain't the problem. The socialization of violence is the problem. Our children are being socialized into a criminal society by criminal values, by a criminal system. And you want to know whether they're violent or not. Get it together. In Palestine, the young kids are not shooting each other. They're throwing rocks and tanks that's occupying their community. All over the world, where people rise up against oppression and tyranny, the young people rise up and fight in the forefront. You ain't fighting for nothing. That's why your kids are killing each other. You need to fight for something. Stand up for something. Be something. Let your community have some respect. When they kill our children in the streets, don't march down the road talking about you want the police chief to leave. Take control of the police department and let the police department police your community based on your needs, based on what you think is important, not based on what some crackle in Trenton thinks is important. So you're not here to fight violence. You're here to empower yourself, to empower your community, to inspire our children to achieve better things in life. You know, just recently the Seattle Seahawks won a championship. They weren't expected to win. But the kids that beat the best team that they expected to win came from the ghetto. They came from the hood. The premier running back's father drove a dump truck for 25 years with one eye. Every success our children have, they have it because of the families, the mothers and the brothers and sisters that stood behind them and encouraged them and helped them. That's the success story. Don't believe the hype. Our children can achieve whatever we want them to achieve. You have to get your act together as a parent, as an adult, and understand that violence is American as apple pie.
Yeah, that's true.
They don't recruit your son and tell him to be all they can be, to be nonviolent. They're strong, and then there's army strong. That's what they tell your ass, right? And army strong is the helicopters, is bringing the hurt, is bringing the pain on somebody else, right? That's army strong. Well, what's strong in the black community? When I said, power to the people, y'all mumble. There's power to the people. How are you going to achieve control and power over your destiny? How are you going to get these absentee landlords to improve your property if you don't understand capitalism? If you don't understand that his property rights supersede your human rights to decent housing? His property rights supersede your human rights to decent property. So you know what we used to do back in the days when we found that out? We used to take the building that the absentee landlord owned and take it over. If he didn't give us heat, we gave ourselves heat. And then when he tried to collect the rent, we would whip his ass if he gave that building for some money. You need to take all these institutions in your community and stop moaning to your elected officials about reforms that don't reform, and conclusions that don't conclude, and solutions that don't solve nothing.
That's true.
Violence is not the issue. The issue is the socialization of our innate character and disposition for violence. They socialized our children to hate each other. We don't believe and trust each other. We despise each other. We talk behind our backs to each other. We don't support each other when we're down. We believe that a fool in a silk suit is successful, and a wise man in rags is a fool. You follow a silk suit Negro in the White House, but you won't listen to a preacher in rags in the old community who's telling you to empower yourself. and will sacrifice his time to make it happen. Not someone that wants to make a career out of being a politician, or Cory Booker, or a Barack Obama. So I'm done. That's my time. I know you always want to hear. Y'all can check. Now I'm gonna ask you something. I'm gonna say something.
Power to the people.
Power to the people.
Power to the people.
Power to the people.